Hello, hello, Crystal here. Welcome to another video with the Interactive Immersive HQ. In this video, I'm going to cover some simple touch designer habits and tips that will make you more of a pro. And these are habits and tips I gained from working in touch designer for a while and also working in commercial projects that I think are often hard to learn if you're self-learning or just watching tutorials because they're not necessarily the most flashy little things, but they will make you work so much better. And I'm excited to share this with you. So let's begin. Often when you're starting learning touch designer, your network could start getting busy really fast. It's good to keep your project organized, especially if you're working with a few different people or if you're working in a commercial project and you need to give this project to someone else to carry on. You want them to know what your network is doing or how you organize it. One good way is using comps. So having base comps for different things and naming the comps. So maybe having comps for just for assets or one for all the inputs that could include having touch connects. So having another base comp inside for all your connect input or all your OSC input. It is often helpful for you to also, when you later on, if you have a few months of time that you come back, you know what exactly is in your project rather than having a bunch of different comps and you have no labels on it, or if you just have a bunch of squiggly lines everywhere, it is saving you effort and time later on. And it might in the beginning, you feel like you're taking a lot of time just organizing your network, but it will save you more time later on. So everyone works differently. And I know some people who don't like to use a bunch of comps and have everything nested inside because they find it hard to find what they need when it is necessary. So another way to keep your things organized, but not having to have put things all in different comps is using annotation. And annotations and comments is a newer feature that I believe that is in TouchDesigner 2021 above, and it is wonderful. So how you do annotation, you use a shortcut key Shift A, and this annotation box opens. And also, so annotation box, you can label it anything you want. I'm going to just call this assets. And you should have this color box on the corner where you can also change the color of the annotation box. And if you don't have this color box, you can have it come out by doing the shortcut key C and it'll come back. And what's cool is if whatever is in the annotation box, for example, if I have a bunch of these movie file ins for this assets annotation, and I have it to be inside of this annotation box, whenever I move this, whatever's inside will move it with it. And I can also put notes in this annotation. If I click on the box, I can also change different parameters, changing how the title, how big I want, and you can play around with these settings. You can also do a comment by using Shift C, and the comment is also somewhat a newer feature in TouchDesigner and is wonderful, where you can put comments, whatever you want, inside your network. So this is very helpful if you later on wants to put different like post-its around your network so you remember what you are doing, or if you're working with multiple people that when they open, you can see why they put different things in different parts in your network. Same with the annotation box, you can change the color of the comments. And if you want to change the parameters on this, right click and click on parameters, and then you can change the font size and the what is in the text in the body. So before having the ability to comment, oftentimes what people would do text stats, and now no longer do we have to do text stats. We can use comments. Maybe you have a base comp and It has a bunch of things inside. So, example, a movie file in with a level, with a, and there's a noise that is composite, have a switch with a, that's out. Just a random made up network. I want to have an ability to be able to change these parameters, change the levels, change the amplitude of this noise, and be able to switch without having to always go inside. If there are certain parameters I know that I am constantly want to be changed, one thing I can do is create a custom parameters. And custom parameters, when I learned it, I was like, this is great. How do you do custom parameters? What is custom parameters? You right click on a comp and you go to custom components. And this window comes up. The first page, the first line, you make a page. So I'm going to call this custom for now. And there's two ways to do the parameters. You can make one. So for example, I want to switch and I know I just want to do 0 to 1. So I can make this into a toggle. And see over here in this parameters box, I have a page, a custom page that is on the bottom. And then I have whatever parameter I did. So this is not linked to anything. So if I want to link this, I would not in the component editor, but in the parameter box, I will right click, copy parameters, go inside, go to the parameters I want to do. So if I want to do the switch, find that parameter and right click and paste bind. There's all these different types of way of pasting, paste expression, paste reference, paste bind. But whenever you do custom parameters, I highly recommend to do paste bind. And what's different from paste reference, paste expression versus paste bind is if you do paste bind, it connects it both ways. So if I change the custom parameters from the parameter box, from the comp, or I've changed it inside in the actual node operator, it will change together. So I'm going to split this plane so I can show you what I mean. I see this. If I switch this, it changes the parameter here. But also if I switch this, it changes the level up. Versus if I paste reference, if I did this, it switches on the bottom. But if I go here, this chain breaks, because it's only one direction if it's reference, but if I bind, it's double direction. So if you do custom parameters, make sure you paste bind, and you'll know when it's purple that it is paste bind. So this is one way of doing custom parameters. Another way is if I go back to the comp and I do custom components and I open this box, if I know what parameters I want to change, for example, I want to be able to affect this noise amplitude, I can also directly drag this the parameter I want into the component editor. And then I choose a bind par as master. This will name it the exact same thing as this parameter, other than the fact that it's a capital A rather than a lowercase a. But now I have it bind directly to it. So two different ways of doing custom parameters. And you can do this to pretty much all the parameters you want. So if I want to be able to change the invert on this, I can change it here or down here, and it affects both ways because they're binded. Custom parameters are great. And then it's especially helpful if you're doing a VJ set, then all the parameters you want to affect can be up here rather than you have to go down and affect it. And then you can have like a MIDI player to be a reference to the custom parameters without having to go directly inside. This seems like a simple tip, but it is, I think, quite important, is spelling TouchDesigner correctly. TouchDesigner is one word with the D and the T capitalized, and not two words. And this is actually a very common mistake, but when I see someone spell TouchDesigner wrong, I immediately know they're a beginner. In the beginning, when I first someone corrected me, I thought, what's the big deal? You know what I'm talking about. But it is important to spell it right. If you have a show and you have a window comp that you are outputting out, and there's all these different parameters, but one thing that I think is quite common that make sure you have is to have borders off. Because when you have borders on, you're going to see your taskbar, and that's not something necessary. It breaks illusion when you're having a show if you can see the computer's borders. And different things that always also to keep note is whether you want your cursor on. Especially if you're sharing the same window as your computer, you probably would want it to be never. So things that you should always do to have a window comp is have borders off and consider whether or not you want to see your cursor. Maybe you have a lot of movie file ins and with different movies, MP4s, MOVs, and you notice your network is dropping a lot of frames, that it's slowing down and you don't know why. And it might be because you have not the most efficient codec. So what codec is best for TouchDesigner? The best codecs that are often used for shows that will make everything faster would be HAPQ, and Notch LC. How do you get these codecs? So HAP and HAPQ are in TouchDesigner. So if you do a movie file out, you notice that some of the codecs option is HAP and HAPQ. So you could, a really quick, cheap way to convert your video into HAP or HAPQ is having a movie file in, have the video you want to be converted, and have it saved as HAP or HAPQ and record and stop recording. And that will make that video into a HAP or HAPQ. Notch LC is a free codec that is provided by Notch Builder that you can download. So if you just look up Notch LC, you should have a link from notchlc.notch.1 and can download it. And then you can change the codec using like a media encoder in Adobe to be able to change the file to Notch LC. The files for HAP and HAPQ is quite big, but it makes things so much faster in TouchDesigner. So if you have a project that you know you have a lot of movie files, the first thing to do, I recommend, is just convert all the videos to Notch LC or HAPQ. Then you won't end up noticing that you're dropping a bunch of frames and needing to do that later. Those are some simple habits and tips that will make you more of a pro in TouchDesigner. In the comments below, let me know if you learned something new or if you know all of it. And if you want to see more videos similar to this, because I can also always share more little tips and habits that will make your process a little bit more seamless. And till next time, bye!
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you're serious about taking your TouchDesigner and interactive skills to the next level, I highly recommend you check out the Interactive and Immersive HQ Pro. It's the only educational resource and community of its kind for TouchDesigner and interactive professionals. You can learn more by checking out the link in the description. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you're new here, don't forget to hit subscribe and the little bell icon for more awesome free content.